Very good morning, students. Let us start our today's class with a prayer. God, grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, courage to change the things I can, and the wisdom to know the difference. Amen. Dear children, we are going to see the second lesson in physics, force and pressure. So by learning this lesson, we could be able to understand the concept of force and its effects, differentiate thrust and pressure, understand the characteristics of atmospheric and liquid pressure, apply Pascal's law in day-to-day life, etc. So what we are going to learn in this lesson? Let us enter into the lesson. In our daily life, we may come across many objects which are at rest, which are also in motion. If we want to make an object to move from one place to another, what will we do? We usually apply two things. One, we push. Other thing, we will pull. Push or pull on the object will make the object to move from rest to motion. So this pull and push is called force. A force acting in a particular area produces pressure. So this is the relationship between force and pressure. What is force? The push or pull is called force. A force acting in a particular area produces pressure. If, for example, if you want to fasten a nail on the wall, pressure is exerted. If we think upon pressure, it doesn't mean that it only works on solids. It also works on liquids, gases, etc. Gases and liquids can also exert pressure upon other things. Hydraulic lift and hydraulic brake are few examples for liquid pressure. We are going to learn these things detailly in this lesson. So, what is force? If we want to open a door, kicking a football, striking a carom coin, etc. To do this activity, we need an external agency. This external agency is called force. Force can either set an object at rest, or it can make an object to move, or it can change the direction. These are all the three important things that a force is doing. It can make an object to move. It can make an object to remain rest. Otherwise, it can change its shape and direction, size of the object. So, force is defined as the external agency which changes or tends to change the state of rest or state of uniform motion of a body, or the direction of the moving object, or the shape of the body. So this is the definition for force. Okay, see why they use the term tends to change. For suppose if you push the wall with your hand, the wall will not move, but you tend to move the wall from the place to another, but it will not happen. That means if it is not happen, means you did not apply force? No. You are applying force, but it doesn't do any work. So that is the relationship between force and work. So force may do work, force may do not work, but overall force is applied. That is the matter. Okay. So will change or tend to change the state of rest, state of uniform motion, or the direction. Greater the force you apply on a body, greater the effect will be. If you apply the greater force, for example, we are seeing cricket match. If the batsman hit the ball very strongly with the great force, means it will reach the boundary. Otherwise, it is running inside the ground. So, to make a great change, great effort, force should be applied in a great way. For suppose take a balloon and you want to burst it, what will you do? You use a pin to burst it. See the picture given in your book. There are number of pins put on the table, and they try to press the balloon. The balloon is not burst. I did this experiment in my class for 6th standard students. You can also try this one at your home. Okay. A single pin produces a larger pressure over a small area, but when large number of pins prick a body, each pin exerts very little pressure on the balloon. As applied force gets distributed over a large surface of the body, so the balloon will not burst. So what can we conclude? The effect of a force depends on the magnitude of the force and the area over which it acts. The force acting perpendicularly on any given surface area of a body is known as thrust. The force acting on an area is pressure. If the force acting perpendicularly on any given surface of the area is known as thrust. It is also measured by the unit Newton. I hope you remember the unit of force is Newton. The unit for thrust is also Newton. Now we shall see the pressure. The effect of force can be measured using a physical quantity called pressure. It can be defined as the amount of force or thrust acting perpendicularly on a surface area of 1 square meter of a body. I repeat. This is the definition for pressure. So this is the definition for pressure. It can be defined as the amount of force or thrust acting perpendicularly on a surface of area of 1 square meter of a body. Pressure is equal to thrust or force divided by area. That is P is equal to F by A. So what is the unit for force? Unit for force is Newton. What is the unit for area? Unit for area is meter square. So this is the unit for pressure, 1 Newton meter square. Otherwise, Pascal is the another unit for pressure. You can call the unit as Pascal, otherwise Newton meter power minus 2. Pressure exerted by a force depends on the magnitude of the force and the area of contact. So by seeing this formula, we can conclude that the pressure is directly proportional to the force and inversely proportional to the area. What is the meaning directly proportional? If the force increases, the pressure will also increase. This is direct proportion. The pressure is inversely proportional to area. What is the meaning? If the area of contact decreases, the pressure will increase. That's what happened in the case of this balloon. Okay. In this balloon experiment, the area of contact increases, so the pressure decreases, the effect is zero, the balloon is not burst. Okay, so to increase the pressure, we should increase the area, otherwise decrease, sorry, to increase the pressure, we should increase the force, otherwise we should decrease the area. Increase the force or otherwise decrease the area, we can increase the pressure. Okay. That's why the axe, nail, knife, injection needle, bullet, etc. are having sharp fine edges so as to exert a large pressure on a smaller area of a body in order to produce maximum effect. Few more examples are given. More number of wheels are provided for a heavy good carrier for decreasing the pressure, thereby increasing the area of contact and the road. So by increasing the area, we can decrease the pressure exerted by that container truck on the road, so the road remains safely. Okay. Broader straps are provided on a backpack for giving less pressure on the shoulders. You will experience, if the straps are very thin, you will feel a great force, great effort, but if the straps are broader, you can easily carry your school bags, isn't it? So one interesting problem is given. Problem number 1, the average weight of an elephant is 4000 newton. The surface area of the sole of its foot is 0.1 meter square. Calculate the pressure exerted by 1 foot of an elephant. So this is the problem. Very interesting, no? Average weight of the elephant is 4000 newton. So it is weight is equal to pressure. Sorry, weight is equal to force, because weight formula is mg, force formula is ma. If the acceleration is only due to gravity, means force can be considered as weight. That's why they have given the unit newton here for weight. Is it clear? Weight of one leg, force exerted by one leg is 4000 divided by 4, that is equal to 1000 newton. Area of sole of 1 foot is 0.1 meter square. Formula for pressure, force by area, 1000 divided by 0.1 is equal to 10000 newton meter power minus 2, otherwise 10000 pascal we can say. This is the pressure exerted by one leg of the elephant. Okay, now we are going to see pressure exerted by air. Dear children, while listening to news in the weather report, you may come across the word in rainy season, atmospheric pressure. What do you mean by atmospheric pressure? Atmospheric pressure is lower or higher. These terms are used in your weather report news. Yes. What do you mean by this atmospheric pressure? Let us know that. You all know very well that everything is filled with air around us. This envelope of air is called as atmosphere. It extends up to many kilometers above the surface of the earth. So all the objects on the surface of the earth experience a pressure or a thirst, because it acts normally towards the surface. So we can call that pressure as thirst. Thrust or force due to this atmosphere. The amount of force or weight of the atmospheric air that act downward on unit surface area of the surface of the earth is known as atmospheric pressure. So it is measured using a device called barometer, and it is invented by Torricelli. Atmospheric pressure, when the atmospheric pressure decreases, the atmosphere pressure decreases with altitude from the surface of the earth. It can be measured by the height of the mercury column in a barometer. The height of the mercury column denotes the atmospheric pressure at that place at a given time in millimeter of mercury. So it is at the height of 76 centimeter or 760 millimeter. The pressure exerted by this mercury column is considered as the pressure of the magnitude 1 atmosphere, 1 atm, 1 atmosphere. 1 atmospheric pressure is defined as the pressure exerted by the mercury column of height 76 centimeter in barometer. It is equal to 1.01 in 10 to the power 5 newton meter power minus 2. This is an 1-word question. In the SI system, 1 atmospheric pressure is equal to 1 lakh pascal. So SI unit for atmospheric pressure is newton meter power minus 2 or pascal. In order of newton meter square, it is 1.01 in 10 to the power 5 newton meter square. So there is an interesting question. Why the cooking in a place located at a higher altitude is difficult? Because at higher altitude, due to lack of atmospheric pressure, the boiling point of the substances reduces. So even at 80 degree it boils. So that 80 degree thermal energy will not sufficient for the food items to cook. So it is not cooked properly. So it is difficult to cook at the high altitudes. Okay. And activity 2 is also explaining you about this atmospheric pressure. Take a flask, conical flask, put a boiled egg at the edge, at the mouth of the conical flask. It will not enter into the conical flask easily. It is held tightly at the mouth itself. But put a burn of paper which is burning, and drop it inside the flask and wait for a few seconds to burn fully. Now keep the egg on the mouth of the flask, and what will happen? It will easily enter into the conical flask. Why it is happening? Just because the oxygen present in the air inside the conical flask is used up for the combustion. it is burning, no? So the oxygen is used up. This reduces the pressure of the air in the flask. So outside it is high pressure, inside the flask is low pressure. What will happen? The air flow from high to low. So high pressure to low pressure, the air tend to flow, but in that process the egg is pushed inside the conical flask. Okay, this is what happening due to the rainy season. The koora vidala parandu podala, just because due to the atmospheric pressure is very low outside, but which is high inside the house. So due to that, it remove all the things in the roof, at the roof, and this is what happening in the rainy days. Okay, next we need to see force and pressure in liquid. Consider a floating object. You would have noticed that an upward force is exerted by water on a floating or a partially submerged body. This upward force is called buoyant force. This phenomenon is known as buoyancy. This force is not only exerted by liquid but also by gases. This upward force decides whether an object will sink or float. If the weight of the object is less than the upward force, then the object will float. If it is not, it will sink. So it depends upon the weight. This is the case what happens in the case of ship. It floats on the sea, it sink in the river. Pressure exerted by liquid. So what is the pressure exerted by liquid? The liquid exert a pressure not only on the base of the container but also on the all the sides of the wall. It exerts pressure. The pressure exerted by a liquid depends on the depth of the point of observation consider in it. See this activity 3. In this activity 3, a plastic bottle is taken and you can punch 3 holes in various sides, various height of the bottle, different heights. So now see how the water is flowing. You can do it at your home. It is very easy experiment. So high pressure, so at the lower point, low pressure at the middle, very low pressure at the top. So if the depth increases, the pressure of the water also increases. Though pressure of the water increases with depth. This is the observation we observed using activity 3. Okay. Take activity 4. Take a glass tube that is open at both ends. Fix a rubber balloon at the lower end of the tube. Pour some water into the tube. Observe the balloon. Now pour some more water into the balloon and again observe the balloon. The balloon starts bulging outward. So this shows that the pressure exerted by a liquid at the bottom of the container depends on the height of the liquid column in it. Thus we can conclude that liquid exerts the same pressure in all direction. So same pressure in all direction. This was found by the famous scientist called Pascal, named Pascal. So next we need to see what is Pascal law. So take a rubber ball and fill it with the water. Make tiny holes on its surface in many places, different places, and press anywhere on the ball. What will you observe? You can see identical streams of water flowing in all directions from the holes. All the streams of are same. This is due to the fact that the pressure which is applied on the body, on the liquid, is equally transmitted in all the direction. So this is first identified by the French scientist Pascal. So Pascal designated a law. Pascal's law states that the pressure applied at any point of a liquid at rest in a closed system will be distributed equally through all direction of the liquid. This is Pascal's law. So this is your Pascal's law. I repeat the law. The pressure applied at any point of a liquid at rest in a closed system will be distributed equally through all the direction of the liquid. This is Pascal's law. So now what are the applications of Pascal's law? The applications of Pascal's law are following. In automobile service stations, the vehicles are lifted upward using this hydraulic lift, which works as per Pascal's law. Automobile brake system works according to Pascal's law. The hydraulic pressure is used to compress the bundle of cotton or cloth so as to occupy less space. These things you will learn in your higher education. Next, we shall move on to surface tension. They have given you activity 7 to explain you about surface tension. So, in your daily life, have you ever wondered why raindrops are spherical in nature? How does the water rise upward in a tree or plant against the force of gravity? These are all due to this surface tension. The surface tension is the property of a liquid. The molecule of a liquid experience a force which contracts the extent of their surface area as much as possible so as to have the minimum value. The amount of force acting per unit length on the surface of the liquid is defined as surface tension. Its unit is Newton meter power minus 2. The tendency of the water column to minimize the surface area of the water is known as surface tension. Now, what are the applications of surface tension? Surface tension is the reason for many events we see in our daily life. In plants, water molecules rise up due to surface tension. Xylem tissues are very narrow vessel present in plants. Water molecules are absorbed by the roots and these vessels helps the water to rise up due to capillary action, which is caused by the surface tension of water. During heavy storm, ships are damaged due to surface tension of water. By pouring oil or soap powder into the sea, we can reduce the impact. Water striders, insect slides on the water surface easily due to the surface tension of the water. So next we need to see viscous force or viscosity. To know about viscous force or viscosity, you might have come across many liquids in your life like oil, honey, water, kerosene, etc., ghee, etc. Yes. What is the flow of these liquid? Which will flow easily, which will flow hardly from one place to another? So each liquid moves with different speed. Water flows faster than other liquid. Coconut oil flows with a moderate speed. Ghee flows very slowly between the layers of the liquid, which is in motion. There is a frictional force parallel to the layer of the liquid. Liquids are in layer. We should consider the liquid as layer and layer, and there is a frictional force act between the layers of these liquids. This frictional force opposes the motion of the liquid layer which they are in motion. The frictional force acting between the successive layer of the liquid, which acts in order to oppose the relative motion of the layer, is known as viscous force. Such a property of a liquid is called viscosity. Viscous force is measured by the unit called in CGS system, kilogram meter power minus 1, second power minus 1. In SI system, Newton second meter power minus 2. This viscous force and surface tension, these things and all, you will learn very detailedly in your 11th standard, don't worry. It is very easy and interesting. Next, we need to see about friction. We walk on road without falling, but we tend to fall when we walk on wet surface. Why? We walk on the road safely because of the friction between the feet and the road, but the friction is less when we walk on wet surface, so we tend to fall. So this is the reason behind that. What is frictional force? The frictional force or friction arises when two or more bodies in contact move or tend to move relative to each other. It acts always in opposite direction of the moving body. This force produces, why? Because of the geometrical dissimilarities of the surface of the body. Our feet is in different geometry and the floor is in the different geometry. So this is the geometrical dissimilarity. Due to this geometrical dissimilarity, this frictional forces arise. So what are all the characteristics of this frictional force? Friction opposes the motion. It causes wear or tear of the surface in the contact. It produces heat. So these are the characteristics of frictional force. It all confirmly produce heat. What are the types of friction? There are two types of friction, namely static friction and kinetic friction. Static friction, the friction experienced by the body which are at rest, is called static friction. Example, all the objects are rigidly fixed to the surface of the earth due to this static friction. Kinetic friction, friction existing during the motion of bodies is called kinetic friction. It can be further classified into sliding friction and rolling friction. You can understand the things sliding, rolling by the name itself. Okay. What are all the factors affecting friction? First thing, nature of the surface. Moving an object on a rough surface will be difficult, but we easily move it on the smooth surface. It is because friction varies between the surfaces. For rough surfaces, friction is more. For smooth surfaces, less friction. Weight of the body. It is easy to pedal your cycle without any load on its carrier. If a load placed on its carrier, it is difficult. So, the weight on the carrier increases the friction between the surface of the tire and the road. Third thing, area of contact. For a given weight, the friction is directly related to the area of contact between the two surfaces. If the area of contact is greater, then the friction will be greater too. A road roller has a broad base, so it offers more friction on the road. But a cycle has the less friction, since the area of contact of the tire with the surface of the road is less. There are many advantages in friction. As we are walking, that is also the effect of friction. Friction is necessary for our day-to-day life. It is desirable in most of the situation of our daily life. We can hold object in our hand due to friction only. We can walk on the road because of friction. The friction between footwear and the ground help us to walk without slipping. The tire designs. There are a lot of designs on the tire. Why? To produce sufficient friction, the designs are produced in the tires. Car tire, cycle tire, etc. Writing on the paper with a pen is easy due to this friction. Automobiles can move easily due to friction between the tires and the road. Brakes can be applied due to frictional resistance on the brake shoes. We are able to light a matchstick, a sew cloth, tie a knot or fix a nail on the wall because of this friction alone. So there are a lot of advantages. Though frictions have a lot of advantages, there are some inconvenience or disadvantages in friction due to friction. What are they? Frictions wear out the surface, rubbing with each other like screws or gears in machines or soles of shoes. Okay, so it wear out. Second thing, an excess amount of effort has to be given to overcome the friction while operating a machine. This leads to wastage of energy. So excess amount of effort has to be needed to overcome this frictional effort in mechanical things. Friction produces heat, which causes physical damage to the machine. So these are all the disadvantages. You can feel the you can feel the heat in the regulator of your fan. That is also one kind of resistance. Okay. Increasing and decreasing friction. How can we increase or decrease this friction? Area of contact. Friction can be increased by increase the area of contact, as we have seen earlier. Second thing, using lubricant, we can reduce the friction. So the lubricants are used in the machineries. What is the common lubricant you use in cycle? Coconut oil or oil you use to lubricate, make easy to ride on the cycle. In tailoring machine, your mom, your aunt will use coconut oil to make it to run easily, to avoid friction. Using ball bearing, since rolling friction is smaller than sliding friction, sliding is replaced by rolling with the usage of ball bearing. For the same reason, lead shots are used in the bearing of the cycle hoop. So this is what given in your second lesson, overall things about surface tension, friction, pressure, thrust. These are all the things explained. Little thing in 8th standard. You will learn about these things detailly in your forthcoming classes. I hope you all understand the lesson. Study well, improve your science knowledge. All the best.